Hello folks, I'm here, Coach Comprido, and today we're going to talk about some stuff that drive the coaches crazy. First thing is the what if question. The what if question is when your coach is explaining a technique and then you go there and say, but what if, you know, he's saying, look, you are on the mount position and you're doing this and this and that. And then you say, but what if he put me on the close guard? So that it is another position. It is another technique that will be a subject for another day. It's not a problem to ask questions, but normally when you do what if, you change the technique that he was explaining to you. You know, you have doubts about that technique, that situation he explained you, that mount position, how to position your leg, how to position your hand, how to position your body. It is okay, but when you start always asking what if, and then if it's one time, it is okay. When you always ask, but what if this, what if that, what if this, what if that, that's super annoying. No coach like that. You take him completely out of subject. He don't want to talk about guard pass, he want to talk about mount. Okay, so stay away from the what if question. Question that you should not ask. No coach wants to answer, when do he gonna give you a belt? You're gonna get a belt when he thinks you're gonna give a belt. You are not paying membership to get a belt. You're paying membership to learn jiu-jitsu. I can tell you this up front. You know when you're gonna get the belt? When you learn jiu-jitsu. That's when you're gonna get the belt. Now, some schools have rules to give you belt. They say, if you do 30 classes, you get a stripe. If you do 100 classes, you get a belt. If that's the case on the academy that you go, they will let you know that. You don't have to keep asking them. They will have a track system, you know? I have some kind of track system on my academy, but that's not something that I take in consideration. The consideration for a person to get the belt is the amount of development the person had. You know, how much more jiu-jitsu they know. Once you get to this level, you're gonna get the belt. Don't ask, okay? He knows, that's his job to know. Don't ask, it's not cool. Nobody likes, no coach likes that answer, that question. Another thing, please, if you are entering the mat or if you're leaving the mat, you have to let the coach know. One thing is if you enter the mat on the beginning of the class, that's okay. You still should to go and say hi to your coach and bow to him, if that's the way you do in your academy, or shake his hand. But you come late, you walk inside of the class, that's super disrespectful, you know? Imagine you are working and somebody just come inside your office, not even knock on the door or nothing. You will not like that, right? So when you arrive on somebody's class, go and, you know, wait when the coach is not talking with somebody else, not doing nothing. Excuse me, coach, can I go in? You're gonna probably say yes, please come in. If you have to leave, if you have to go to the bathroom, if you have to drink water, if you have to go home earlier, he needs to know. Many times I was teaching a class and I was thinking a student of mine was there, and then I started looking for the guy just to know that the guy was walking away, he's on the locker room changing. It's one thing that if you get hurt and if you're bleeding or if you're feeling sick, that's something that you have to run to the bathroom right away. Maybe you don't have time to talk with your coach. But when you're just walking, when you're just, you know, get tired, want to drink water, want to go to the bathroom, like those things, ask. You're going to say it's okay to go. Don't be rude, okay? Another thing, like especially this is especially on the seminars, okay? When you go to a seminar, the person who is teaching the seminar is there to teach you technique. As on the academy, okay, your instructor is there to teach you technique. Some people like to training at seminars. I personally don't like to training at seminars. I like to go there and teach technique, you know. Would be impossible to train with everybody. Some people do that. I saw Hickson do that several times, training with everybody, and I think that's amazing. I tried to do a couple times, and it's super tiring. But you know, many times I was late to take a flight and I have people stopping me, hey, let's roll, and even in a rude way. You know, it's one thing if you go and say, hey coach, if you have opportunity, one of these days I would love to roll with you. Man, I will be glad to roll with you, and I'm sure any coach will be glad to roll with you when he has the opportunity. But you have to keep in mind, many times the guy, when he arrived in a seminar, he had a late flight or an early morning flight, you know, he was hurt. He's not there to be tested. He's there to share his jiu-jitsu. Don't take me wrong. It's people I know, is a bunch of people who love that stuff. Most of people don't. So if you have to call somebody to training, always be polite, even inside of your academy. You know, especially if you're a lower belt approaching a higher belt. Don't put your chest up and go, hey, let's roll. It will not be pleasure. I promise you. When this happens and the guy gonna train with you, then he's gonna wanted to teach you a lesson, and that's not the point. As a coach, one of the things that upset me most is when I go there, I explain the technique, you know, I give you all the information I have about the subject, and then I look and then I see not just that you are not doing the technique that I show, but you are teaching a technique that has nothing to do with what I just teach. You're just changing the technique that I taught, and they were trying to show to somebody else. That's very common on the lower belts, what is even more upsetting. You not even know enough for you, and you wanna try to show to somebody else. You know, you are there learning, somebody teach you something. You are in the moment that you should be replicating the technique that the person showed you, that your instructor showed you. Replicate the technique. You can tell that person, your training partner, hey, dude, later I want to show you a technique that I do really well. I encourage that kind of stuff. I think it's awesome when we trade information. But everything has a right time to be done. Not right after the coach show a technique to everybody. That's super disrespectful as well. I can guarantee you no coach likes when you as a parent are trying to coach your kid. No coach like that. Most likely, you are not a jiu-jitsu practitioner, and even if you are, you do not know what the coach are trying to achieve at that moment. And the fact that you are coaching your kid, even if you know what you're saying, will force the parent to the other kid to do the same. And then the parent of the other kid who do not train in jiu-jitsu will be just yelling, and then become a shouting contest. And this is terrible on the academy. We don't want to create rivalry on the academy, especially in between kids. When you are there, watch your kid training, and that's it. That's it. Don't coach your kids. You can talk with him later. You can ask your coach. You can ask the coach, hey coach, what do you think my kids should be doing? That will be fine. He's gonna explain what you are trying to achieve during the class. He's gonna explain you. But do not coach. Do not shout during the class. That is very disrespectful. That's gonna be disturb the class, that's gonna be bad for your kid, that's gonna be bad for everybody else. Last but not least, dude, if you tap, do not complain. Do not hit the floor. Do not curse. Shut up, swallow. Start to training again, okay? Start to thinking what you did wrong and what you can do to improve. If you submit somebody, do not celebrate. You know, I don't care if you submit Bushesha, do not celebrate. You are training. You know, maybe you are training with Bushesha to kill him, to prove that you're the best fighter in the world. Most likely Bushesha is just trying to have fun and warm up with you. Okay, so you do not know the demeanor that your opponent is having at the time, so do not celebrate. That's not cool, that's disrespectful. And it's very disrespectful when somebody managed to beat you, managed to make you tap, that you hit the floor, that you start to curse. If you don't believe the technique was good one, if you do something that's illegal, you know, you said, hey man, cool, you tap me, but like we do not do heel hooks here at the academy, okay? So just to let you know, but it was a good technique. Thank you very much. I appreciate the attack, okay? Learn with your mistakes, and that's the only way you're gonna improve. I do not know champion, I do not know no champion who never tap. Everybody taps in training. Just tap, start again, being tapped again, start again. My first competition, I tapped. I was there for my second, my third, and I tapped many times since then. Do I like to tap? No, I hate. But I understand it's part of the learning. Okay, so do not be upset. That's what I have for you today. Please say, please like, subscribe, send me an email, kiss to my mom, hugs to my dad, you know, check my new guinea pig, and that's it. We talk soon.